each and every one of your smiling faces here this evening.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Welcome to the 152nd Christmas celebration in the Montana Baptist Church. Wow. Oh, I forgot that. Are we on?
Yep.
I get a little bit excited, you know. I don't want to get ahead of technology, even though technology's way ahead of me.
Yeah. Me too.
All right.
Me too.
Welcome here. It is good to see each and every one of you here this evening as we gather together to gloriously praise our Savior, Jesus Christ, and Him coming to earth that we could spend eternity with Him. And we just praise the Lord for that. And all the Christmas trappings and things of that nature, we are here to celebrate. And for those of you that have small ones in the house, remember these words. Some assembly required.
Some assembly required.
Oh, yes. We remember those days. Welcome. And we hope this time this evening is glorifying to you, to the Holy Spirit moving mightily among His people. It is good to see each and every one of you here today. We'll now have our Advent reading.
On this most holy day, we light all four candles in our Advent wreath, and we are reminded of the expectation, preparation, proclamation, and revelation of His coming. We light the Christ candle. We rejoice that the promise of God has been fulfilled in the coming of the baby born in a manger. Let us pray. Gracious and mighty King, we celebrate your goodness to us as we join the triumph and joy of Christmas. As your love has been reveled in all of its fullness, we pray that love may abound in our hearts during this special day. Grant us the Spirit of Christ that we may live in the fullness of his character every day. In his name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for that, for the Advent reading. Thank you to all who throughout the last 5 weeks have participated in providing assistance in lighting the candles, even though the first time that the candles were a little difficult to light, but it worked out.
Mary saved the day.
All right. Let's very quickly go to the Lord. Lord, we come to you, and Lord, we with our hearts that are open before you. Lord, you who left the realms of glory and came to earth in a small child. Lord, that child was fully man and fully God. He left heaven to come to earth so that we could come to him, our omniscient Father, our all-knowing God. And you did all of this out of love. And Lord, may we reciprocate that love at this time of the year and throughout every day of our lives. The kind of love that you shared with your greatest creation, made in the image of you. And Lord, we just thank you so much for the gift of Jesus Christ, our Savior, and our soon coming King, our Lord. It's in his name that we pray. Amen. Join with me now as we read responsibly number 268 in the blue hymnal. And it's also up there on the overhead or on the screen. Overhead. They went away a long time ago, didn't they? All right. I told you, technology's way ahead of me. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be for all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with all the multitude of heavenly hosts praising God, saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
Amen. You notice that portion there where it says, "It will be for all people." We talked about that last week, or maybe 2 weeks ago. That, you know, in Scripture, when it says all, you know what that means? All. The Lord Jesus came for all who would accept him as their Savior. Join us now as we sing number 285. O Holy Night.
Thank you. Suddenly a light appeared, an angel close. associated with Christmas that we do, like the wreath, the trees, candles, and gifts, they lead us to think about God and his love for us. We sing carols and give others gifts as we celebrate Jesus' birthday, but we must not forget that Christmas is truly about God's love for us, his children. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Thank you. Very true. All right. We now have sing a hymn, number 261, Away in a Manger.
Thank you.
Thank you. Man will live forevermore because of Christmas. All right. Our next hymn, found in 250 in the blue hymnal, is O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Asking if I was singing Mary Did You Know tonight, and Cora really loves the song, so she wanted to try to sing along, so Emma's going to help us too.
Josh for setting that up. That particular song sets the theme, sets the stage for this brief message. It's entitled, A Parent's Reflection. You know, it's hard to lose Jesus when we see the world that has been desensitized as to the reason that we celebrate Christmas. It can get distracted amongst all the parades, the glitz, the glitter, you know, the packages, the shopping, and all of these, all the trappings that surround Christmas and the reason that we celebrate Christmas. It is Jesus Christ who came to this earth to redeem sinful man, sinful humanity. And he did it out of love. But can you imagine what was going through the hearts and the minds of both Mary and Joseph? For over 1,700 years, there had been the 50 or more prophecies proclaiming the one to come, the Messiah to come from the Old Testament, clear through into the New Testament, the coming of the Messiah. Watching and waiting, the prophets would proclaim, finally arrived. Doesn't say where the angel of the Lord spoke to Mary, but to her, it was a fulfillment of every young maiden's dream. Maybe I would be the one to be in the womb for the Messiah. A virgin shall conceive. Maybe it would be me. And here, Mary is selected because of her obedience to God. I was sure that she was well versed in what the prophets had proclaimed. And the same with Joseph, her betrothed husband. He was obedient to God himself. And he was also obedient to the civil authorities of that day. Do you know that if Mary had aborted that child, we wouldn't have Jesus? If Joseph had taken a more public display or dispensation for their union, we wouldn't have Jesus. But Joseph was a just man. And he loved Mary, even though he was a few years older than he and she, and it was in their culture a more or an arranged marriage. But he was a provider. He was a carpenter, a house builder by trade. And the news that Mary would share with Joseph that she was carrying a child. Wow, how can that be since I've known no man? And the thoughts that would have run through Joseph's mind, was Mary unfaithful to me? But the steadfastness of Mary and her beliefs that was well grounded, she was able to withstand the whispers at the well. You know, when the ladies would go early in the morning to get their water. Oh, here comes Mary. You know, she's with child. Oh, yes. The gossip mill and the rumor mill and the outright lies that people contracted rather than to believe that what she was carrying was divine. And the same with Joseph. You think the guys don't gossip? Yeah, they do. Just think what was happening down at the Home Builders Union Hall. You're going to marry her? And that's not your child? But yet, Joseph was a just man. He was obedient to God. And an angel of the Lord told him so. Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. For what she has conceived is from the Lord. And with that, Joseph raised Jesus in accordance to all their rules and tenets of their faith. Along with teaching them a skill to work, to have a job. And Mary, did you know that little child that you gave birth to, when you saw that child, you were looking into the face of God. Mary, did you know that? Did you ever see a new mother when they first hold their child? You know, it's such a beautiful sight. You know, they peel back the covers and they start taking inventory. You know, counting fingers, counting toes. You know. And seeing what's there, expressing that love for that child. But Mary, regardless of all the social stigma, did you know that the child that you bore would deliver the entire world from their sins? Mary, did you know that the locks of hair that you pushed back on that young child's head would someday be penetrated with a crown of thorns? Mary, did you know that those little hands and those little feet would one day be pierced with iron nails? I don't believe she knew or wanted to even know what lay ahead. Mary, did you know that one day that you would see your son lifted high on a cruel cross? Scripture says that she was there and watched her son die. Mary, did you know that just 3 days later you would see your son again? The stone was rolled away. The tomb is empty. Can you imagine the unquestionable amount of joy, jubilant to see your son up from the grave? He arose with a mighty triumph over his foes. He arose a victor from the great domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. Wow. Mary, did you know that? I don't believe she did. And we know that Joseph was quite a few years older than Mary. I think that in her heart, she was sad to see her son be pierced and hung on a cross. And Scripture doesn't bear this out, but Joseph wasn't there at the time. They believe that he had died early. But can you imagine if Joseph had remained living? This is pure speculation from the father's point of view. I believe I would do anything in my power just not to see one of my children abused and beaten and wrongly accused of something that he or she did not do.
and Joseph would have fought tooth and nail to see his son live. To be able to say, you know, how many of us as dads, when, you know, children call up, hey dad, can you come help me with this? Or, you know, you might not be able to physically do the work anymore, but you can have those gray hair wisdom to advise. Yeah. And I think Mary, when she saw Jesus, her son coming from the tomb, and seeing him again, I can only speculate that she was saying, I wish Joseph was here to see that. You see, it was born to die that man may live. All those years, 1700 years of prophets, over 50 of them fulfilled in the coming of Christ. The fulfillment of the prophecies that Jesus would die. He told his disciples that I'm going to go to Jerusalem and be persecuted and crucified. But on the third day, I'm going to rise again. His disciples, in human thought process, couldn't comprehend that. We, as in this time period, it's hard to comprehend, and there's folks out there that don't believe in Jesus, but they believe in Christmas. Without Jesus, we don't have Christmas. Mm-hmm. And Jesus is with us every day. Every day should be like Christmas. You need to come tomorrow morning to hear the rest of the story of that. Jesus, there's no other name. When Mary kissed the face of God, the great I am, Jesus. Stand as we sing our closing hymn. No other name but Jesus. There's just something about that name. Number 83 in the group. And trust him with your eternal soul for all eternity.
Scripture says today is a day of salvation. I encourage you this day to celebrate and join Jesus and for Him to be your Savior for all eternity. Silent night. Candles are lit, we will say. Jesus, who is the light of the world.
Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. By receiving Jesus as our personal Savior, He takes away our sins and gives us open door to heaven. We thank you, Father, for this gift. We ask that now, as we leave, that we may share the true meaning of Christmas with all those around us, with every gift that's open, that we may remember that greatest gift that God gave to us. In Jesus' blessed name, I pray. Thank you all. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen.